In the name of Allah, the most loving and caring. Assalamu alaikum, 8th class. Welcome to online class again. Hope so you all will be fine. This is our lecture number 20 of English. And the topics included in this lecture are From English A, we shall do chapter number 7, Clever Mirchu, translation, paragraph number 5, 6 and 7. Then from English B, we shall do story, Robbers Turned into Good Citizens. First of all, we shall do chapter number 7, Clever Mirchu, translation. And here are the meanings of paragraph number 5, Cried and cried, Roti Rahi, sorrow, gham, plan, mansuba, after all, aakhirkar, die of hunger, bhook se marna, thought and thought, sochti rahi, wished, khwahish, instead, ke bajaye, nicely, umda. Now, this is paragraph number 5. The poor wife cried and cried. She was so full of sorrow to hear this. But at last, as the night wore on, she agreed to her husband's plan. After all, she could not see her children die of hunger. She thought and thought, but no other plan came to her mind. She wished he had only 3 children instead of 7. They could have been fed well and brought up nicely. Now, translation. The poor bechari, wife, biwi, cried and cried, roti rahi, bechari biwi roti rahi, she, wo, was so full of sorrow, intihai ghamzada ho gai, to hear, sunkar, this, ye sunkar wo intihai ghamzada ho gai, but, magar, at last, akhirkar, as, joon joon, the night, रात वोर ऑन गुजरती गई मगर आखिरकार जूं जूं रात गुजरती गई शी वो अग्रिड राजी हो गई टू हर अपने हस्बैंड्स खावन के प्लान मंसूबे वो अपने खावन के मंसूबे पर राजी हो गई आफ्टर ऑल आखिरकार शी वो कुड नॉट सी नहीं देख सकती थी हर अपने चिल्ड्रन बच्चों को डाई ऑफ मरते हंगर भूखा आखिरकार वो अपने बच्चों को भूखा मरते नहीं देख सकती थी शी वो थॉट एंड थॉट सोचती रही बट मगर नो नहीं अदर कोई और प्लान मंसूबा खेम आया टू हर उसके माइंड जहन में वो सोचती रही मगर कोई और मंसूबा उसके जहन में ना आया शी उसने विश्ट ख्वाहिश की शी उसके हैड ओनली 3 होते सिर्फ 3 चिल्ड्रन बच्चे इंस्टेड के बजाय ऑफ 7 7 उसने ख्वाहिश की कि उसके 7 के बजाय सिर्फ 3 बच्चे होते दे उन्हें कुड हैव बीन फेड खिलाया पिलाया जा सकता वेल अच्छा एंड और ब्रॉट अप परवरिश की जा सकती नाइसली उम्दा उन्हें खिलाया पिलाया जा सकता और उनकी उम्दा परवरिश की जा सकती नाउ पैराग्राफ नंबर 6 मीनिंग्स आर्ग्यूड बहस की रेज्ड बुलंद होना वॉइसेस आवाजें Every bit of, sab kuch, unlike, baraks, asleep, soya hua, twilight, dhundlaka, quickly, jaldi se, crept out, nikal gaya, cottage, jhompdi, pretending, bahana karna, called, bulaya. Paragraph number 6. As the woodcutter and his wife argued, they raised their voices. The little Mirchu heard every bit of what they said. Unlike his brothers, he was not asleep. For a long time, he lay thinking what would be the best thing to do. As soon as it was twilight, he got up quickly and crept out of the cottage, and off he ran to the forest. He filled his pockets there with small white stones. Then he ran back to the house and was in bed again, all quiet and pretending to be fast asleep when his mother called him. Now translation. As Jab the woodcutter Lakkar Hare and or his uski wife Bibi argued ne bhas ki. जब लकड़ हारे और उसकी बीवी ने बहस की, दे उनकी रेज्ड बुलंद हो गईं, दे वॉइसेस आवाजें, तो उनकी आवाजें बुलंद हो गईं, द लिटिल छोटे मिर्चू मिर्चू हियर ने सुन लिया एवरी बिट ऑफ सब कुछ व्हाट जो दे उन्होंने सैड कहा. छोटे मिर्चू ने वो सब कुछ सुन लिया जो उन्होंने कहा. अनलाइक बरअक्स हिज अपने ब्रदर्स भाइयों ही वो वॉज नॉट नहीं था एसली सोया. अपने भाइयों के बरक्स वो सोया हुआ नहीं था. फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम काफी देर ही वो ले लेटा थिंकिंग सोचता रहा व्हाट कौन सा वुज भी होगा द बेस्ट बेहतरीन थिंग काम टू डू करना. काफी देर लेटा सोचता रहा कि कौन सा काम करना बेहतरीन होगा. एज सून एज जू ही इट वॉज ट्वाइलाइट सुबह का धुंधला हुआ ही वो गॉट अप उठा क्विकली जल्दी से एंड और क्रैप्ड आउट चुपके से निकल गया ऑफ द कॉटेज झोंपड़ी से. जो ही सुबह का धुंधला हुआ वो जल्दी से उठा और चुपके से झोंपड़ी से निकल गया. एंड और ऑफ ही रैन वो दौड़ा टू द फॉरेस्ट जंगल की तरफ और जंगल की तरफ दौड़ा. ही उसने फील्ड भर ली हिज अपनी पॉकेट्स जेबें दे वहां विद से स्मॉल छोटे वाइट स्फेद स्टोन्स पत्थरों. वहां उसने अपनी जेबें छोटे सफेद पत्थरों से भर ली. देन फिर ही वो रैन बैक टू द हाउस घर की तरफ वापस दौड़ा. फिर वो घर की तरफ वापस दौड़ा. एंड और वॉल्स था इन पर बेड बिस्तर अगेन दोबारा और क्वाइट खामोशी से एंड और प्रिटेंडिंग बहाना किया टू बी फॉस्ट एस्लीप गहरी नींद सोने का. व्हेन जब हिज उसकी मदर माँ कॉल्ड बुलाया हिम उसे और दोबारा खामोशी से बिस्तर पर लेट गया और गहरी नींद सोने का बहाना किया जब उसकी माँ ने उसे बुलाया. Now here are the meanings of paragraph number 7. Gather, इकट्ठे करना. Firewood, आग जलाने वाली लकड़ियाँ. Excited, खुश होना. Completely, मुकम्मल तौर पर. Leading, रहनुमाई में. Lonesome, सुनसान. Deepest, घने. Now this is paragraph number 7. We are all going to the forest. His mother told the boys, "You must all help your father gather firewood, for there is no money left to buy any food." The boys were so excited that they completely forgot about their hunger and were in no time on the way to the forest with their father leading. The forest was dark and lonesome, but the woodcutter knew every bit of it so well that before long, they were right in the deepest part of the forest. Now focus on translation. We, hum, are all going, sab ja rahe hain, to the forest, jungle mein. Hum sab jungle mein ja rahe hain. His, uski, mother, ma, told, ne bataya, the boys, ladkon ko. Uski ma ne ladkon ko bataya, you, tumhe, must, chahiye. All सब help मदद करनी your अपने father बाप gather इकट्ठी करने के लिए firewood आग में जलाने वाली लकड़ियाँ. तुम्हें आग में जलाने वाली लकड़ियाँ इकट्ठी करने के लिए अपने बाप की मदद करनी चाहिए. For क्योंकि there is no money कोई पैसा नहीं left बचा to buy खरीदने के लिए any food खुराक. क्योंकि खुराक खरीदने के लिए कोई पैसा नहीं बचा. द बॉयज लड़के वर सो एक्साइटेड इतने खुश हुए डैट के दे वो कम्प्लीटली मुकम्मल तौर पर फॉरगॉट भूल गए अबाउट देयर हंगर अपनी भूख। लड़के इतने खुश हुए कि वो अपनी भूख मुकम्मल तौर पर भूल गए। एंड और वर इन नो टाइम, जल्द ही ऑन द वे, रास्ते पर थे टू द फॉरेस्ट, जंगल जाने वाले। विद मे देयर, अपने फादर बाप की लीडिंग रहनुमाई में, और जल्द ही अपने बाप की रहनुमाई में जंगल जाने वाले रास्ते पर थे। द फॉरेस्ट, जंगल, वॉज, था, डार्क, तारीख, एंड और लोनसम, सुनसान, जंगल तारीख और सुनसान था। बट मगर द वुड कटर, लकड़हारा, न्यू, वाकिफ था एवरी बिट ऑफ, हर हिस्से से, सो वेल, इतनी अच्छी, डैट के बिफोर लॉन्ग, जल्द ही, दे, वो, वर, पहुंच गए राइट इन द डीपेस्ट, इंतहाई घने पार्ट, हिस्से में ऑफ द फॉरेस्ट, जंगल में, जंगल के। मगर लकड़हारा उसके हर हिस्से से इतनी अच्छी तरह वाकिफ था कि जल्द ही वो जंगल के इंतहाई घने हिस्से में पहुंच गए। Now we shall do story, robbers turned into good citizens. Now here is the story in front of us. You can open this story from your grammar book, page number 9. You have to write difficult meanings also. Okay. Hazrat Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani Rahmatullah Alayh had to undertake a journey when he was yet a young boy. His pious mother stitched up 40 gold coins in his shirt. She advised her son to speak the truth always. He joined a caravan and set off on his journey. When the caravan entered a forest, a gang of robbers fell on the travelers and deprived them of all their valuables. Now, meanings, Hazrat Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani Rahmatullah Alayh had to undertake a journey. Undertake mean to do or begin to do something. Journey mean trip. When he was yet a young boy, his pious mother mean a mother who strongly believes in religions, stitched up 40 gold coins in his shirt. She advised her son to speak the truth always. Advised mean to give someone advice. He joined a caravan and set off on his journey. Caravan means a group of people with vehicles or animals who travel together. When the caravan entered a forest, a gang of robbers mean a group of robbers fell on the travelers. Travelers mean people who travels and deprived them of all their valuables. Deprived mean not having things that are necessary for life. And valuables mean objects that might be sold for lot of money. Now Hazrat Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani Rahmatullah Alayh went on a trip when he was a young boy. The mother of Hazrat Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani Rahmatullah Alayh stitched 40 gold coins into his shirt and advised him always speak the truth. Whatever situation there is. Then he joined a group of people who traveled with him and started his journey. When they entered a forest, a group of robbers caught them and deprived them from all valuables. While they were busy robbing everyone, a robber happened to pass by the young boy. He said, "Boy, do you have anything on you?" "Yes," came the prompt reply. "I have 40 gold coins." The robber asked the young boy to show the money, which he readily did. The robber took the boy to the leader of the gang. While they were busy robbing, robbing means to take money or property illegally. Everyone, a robber is a person who steal, happened to pass by the young boy. He said, "Boy, do you have anything on you?" "Yes," came the prompt reply. Prompt mean to make something happen. "I have 40 gold coins." The robber asked the young boy to show the money, which he readily did. The robber took the boy to the leader of the gang. When they were taking everything from the people, a robber passed through him means a robber passed through Abdul Qadir Jilani and asked him what he has, and he said in reply that he has 40 gold coins. The robber asked him about the money and took him to the leader. Like all other robbers, the leader was also surprised. He said, "Why did you not deny having money?" Hazrat Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani Rahmatullah Alayh told the robber's chief that his mother had advised him to speak the truth always. This had a deep effect on the chief. He said, "Alas, I do not obey the commands of Allah while this little boy so faithfully follows the advice of his mother." Like all other robbers, the leader was so surprised. Surprised means feeling or showing surprise because something has happened that you didn't expect. He said, "Why did you not deny having money?" Deny means to say that something is not true. Hazrat Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani Rahmatullah Alayh told the robber's chief, chief means leader, that his mother had advised him to speak the truth always. This had a deep effect on the chief. Effect means the result of a particular influence. He said, "Alas, I do not obey the commands of Allah." Obey means to act according to what you have been asked, and commands mean orders, while this little boy so faithfully follows the advice of his mother. The leader was also surprised and asked, why did you not deny it? He told him that, "Chief, my mother had advised me to speak the truth always." His saying has great effect on him, and he said, "I do not even obey Allah, and this little boy is following his mother's advice." Remorse became a guideline to show him the right path. He made up his mind to give up his bad ways of earning livelihood. He disbanded the gang and advised all the members to live an honest life. Thus, the example set by Hazrat Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani Rahmatullah Alayh reformed the robbers. He grew up to be a great religious leader and a pious saint. He held in great esteem by millions of his followers and devotees. He is popularly known as Ghausul Azam Jilani. Remorse became a guideline to show him the right path. Remorse means guilt. Guideline means information intended to advise people. He made up his mind to give up his bad ways of earning livelihood. Livelihood mean the money people need to pay for food or place. He disbanded the gang. Disbanded mean to stop being a group, and advised all the members to live an honest life. Thus, the example set by Hazrat Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani Rahmatullah Alayh reformed the robbers. Reformed mean changed and improved. He grew up to be a great religious leader and a pious saint. He held in great esteem by millions of his followers. Esteem means respect for a good opinion of someone, and followers mean people who supports and admires, and devotees mean people who strongly admires a particular person. He is popularly known as Ghausul Azam Jilani. This guilt shows him the right path. He decided to stop earning livelihood in a bad way. He left the gang and advised them also to live an honest life. The example of Hazrat Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani Rahmatullah Alayh changed and improved the robbers. Millions of people, his followers and devotees, always respect him for a good opinion. He is popularly known as Ghausul Azam Jilani. At the end of the lecture, what will be your home task? You have to learn and write Urdu meanings, learn translation, and learn story. Thanks for your attention. Allah Hafiz.